हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू पेबल्स। पेबल्स के स्पोकन हिंदी थ्रू इंग्लिश के क्लास में आपका स्वागत है। नमस्कार। तो चलिए आज हम शुरुआत करते हैं। उससे पहले, शुरुआत करने से भी पहले, लेट मी टेल यू दैट इफ़ यू आर नॉट सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल येट, प्लीज़ डू सब्सक्राइब, प्रेस द बेल आइकॉन एंड डेफिनेटली ऐड द कॉमेंट्स। वी आंसर एवरी कॉमेंट्स। वी आर गॉट मेनी कॉमेंट्स एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू कोप अप विद दैट। एक कॉमेंट ऐसी थी कि सर प्लीज़ टेक द नंबर, डोंट टेक ओनली नंबर्स अप टू 10, प्लीज़ टेक द नंबर्स फ्रॉम 11 टू 20।
वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन दैट।
या आई हैव कमेंटेड दैट यू हैव नॉट वॉच द फुल वीडियो। सो आई रिक्वेस्ट, इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू लर्न द हिंदी इन प्रॉपर वे, स्पोकन हिंदी, सो प्लीज़ वॉच द फुल वीडियो। ओके, जनरली इट्स अ हैबिट दैट वॉचिंग वन और टू थ्री मिनट्स एंड स्किप। Don't do like that, because these are not fun and entertainment videos. You have to watch the videos in full. Otherwise,
if you really want to learn conversation in Hindi,
yeah, exactly. Otherwise, no, because till end we are giving many suggestions,
yes.
Many things we say about the Hindi, Indian culture, different parts of Hindi. So you should know that. Otherwise, you'll not be able to proficient in the spoken Hindi.
Right.
So it is my request. Please watch full video. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, shall we start? Today we are going to start about the vegetables. Sabziyan. So, she has written the word sabziyan.
Sabziyan or sabzi. This word sabziyan means when we talk about plural.
Yeah.
And sabzi means when we talk about one vegetable. So, here we are talking about number of vegetables. And where will you find them? When you go to the market to buy things, you should know the local word. The word, native word, which is spoken in Hindi. That's why we have taken this topic today.
Yeah.
Yes?
And in homes, if you are the guest in some Hindi home, there the prepared one is also called as sabzi. Okay. There is not there is no special names for every kind of vegetable.
Vegetable is also called sabzi.
Sabzi.
So, aaj kaun si sabzi hai? Means today which vegetable you are cooking? So, this is what they will be hearing, all these things. And if you are staying alone, then also these people need vegetables. And these vegetables, when you go to market, you should know what are the Hindi words.
If you are going to the towns or small villages or maybe in the metro cities, big markets, if you don't know the local name, first of all, the seller will not understand what you are talking. And if you are not able to talk in the local language, then the rates are double.
And then you have to actually point out, I want this and I want that.
No.
That becomes difficult actually.
But and the rates are also double.
Yes, double.
Once they understand you are not Hindi, the rates are double. And this is not in India, it is everywhere in the world.
Everywhere we find it.
Everywhere in the world. So better to know the proper names, local names of the vegetables. So let us start.
I think we have taken very common vegetables today.
Yeah.
So, which everyday people eat.
Yeah, but we are not going to make only one video, because there are a list of vegetables. Two, three videos will be there about the vegetables. Video 1, part 1, part 2, part 3.
Right.
So, I will say the English words and she will...
We will write Hindi in English script, and then we will understand about it.
And some vegetables, maybe they are not outside India very famous, so we will show the picture also. Picture of vegetables also will show, so that if in your country
can identify this picture
exactly,
is called
exactly.
This vegetable. Yeah.
So even if you may be calling it something different, but by the picture you will be able
understand.
To understand.
Yeah.
So let us start.
Yeah.
The first is the cabbage.
Cabbage.
Not my favorite. Or
I like it. Cabbage in Hindi is called patta gobhi. So I'll just write it for you. Patta gobhi. Now patta means all leaves. So you know cabbage, when you start separating them, you will find leaves coming out. So patta gobhi. Gobhi is common for another type of vegetable, which is cauliflower. So here it is made up of number of leaves above each other. So isko hum kehte hain patta gobhi.
But if you only say gobhi, that means also cabbage.
Cabbage.
Okay. For cabbage, you need not say patta gobhi. You can only say gobhi.
No, but in northern India, it's very specific. Patta gobhi chahiye ya full gobhi chahiye.
Okay. So in the middle, central part of the India, we can call just gobhi.
You can say gobhi, but to be specific, you should know that it's called patta gobhi.
Patta gobhi. Okay. The second one is cauliflower.
Cauliflower.
Again, not my favorite.
So it is cauliflower is called normal gobi, phool gobi. Actually, it is called phool gobi. Phool means flower. So here we have written flower. So it is called phool gobi. Phool gobi.
In the central part of the India and maybe in the southern part of the India, if you can, you can call it just flower.
So if you come to Maharashtra and you call, you ask, I want phool gobi, they might not understand.
Yeah, exactly.
And if you say flower, mereko ek flower de do, then they will understand.
Yeah, then they will understand. They will give you the cauliflower.
Yeah.
So cauliflower is generally called as flower in central and southern part of the India, but in northern part of the India you have to call it as the phool gobi. Okay. Now the next is the spinach.
Spinach is very common green colored leafy vegetable that is called as palak.
Now this palak is all over India. This is a very famous and everywhere you will get cooked vegetable like a palak along with paneer.
Yes, then palak with the paneer is a very famous
famous dish in India, palak paneer, and some cream is also added on that. It is very famous and it is very good to eat. They can add the baby corn. Now I'll just tell you, if you are going to some big restaurants, there you can ask, you can demand that I want spinach or palak with paneer or with the baby corn or with something else.
Yes.
Mutter. There are different flavors of the cooked vegetable, like you have the palak paneer, means addition.
Corn paneer, aloo paneer,
aloo paneer.
So, aloo and is, palak paneer, and so many things are there.
Okay, so wherever you see the menu card, right, the palak word will be there. Adding aloo means potato, paneer is paneer, then the baby corn, then the mutter is there. And
mutter is peas.
Yeah,
we'll come to mutter also.
Yeah, yes. I think we will do something on the restaurant menu.
Yeah,
separate video.
Tell.
Yeah, separate menu. So now it is the onion.
Yeah, onion or onion. It is called pyaz. Pyaz.
Okay. Now please pay attention to here. You have to say pyaz. Z z z.
Pyaz nahi. Pyaz.
Okay.
Unknowingly, this is a very important ingredient in Indian cooking. Many people cannot cook vegetables.
Important
without,
means it is a must.
Yes, it's a must.
It is must. And
yeah, but you will not find in Jain food.
Yeah.
People who are Jains and they follow Jainism, they do not eat
onion and even garlic. They don't eat
also,
garlic
yeah.
And onion is not there in some kind of specialty
foods.
So
in many restaurants, they may find Jain food separate menu also.
Exactly. Or you can in the bracket it is written Jain food.
Available.
That means in that preparation the onion is not used. Now
yes,
please pay attention to Z.
Z.
It's a pyaz. Z z z is there. If you say pyaz sa, S, if you pronounce S, that means
thirst.
You are thirst.
Yeah.
Pyaz means thirst and pyaz means onion. So please pay attention to this because a very minute difference is there.
Very minute difference.
So next is capsicum.
Now capsicum is a very common vegetable.
Yeah.
It's called as Shimla Mirch.
There is a story that initially it was introduced by British in Shimla, which
Shimla is a
hill station
where
they
brought this and started growing.
Yeah.
And after that, it started, people started calling it Shimla mirch.
But here you have to call it full Shimla mirch.
Yeah.
Because if you only say mirch, that means chili.
Chili.
Okay. Shimla mirch, I'm not talking much about
it's
a
not
test.
So, yeah,
no, it is not spicy at all.
Spicy.
Okay. Next is
carrot. Now, carrot in Hindi is called gajar. Gajar.
Okay. Now, before going ahead, let me tell you about this. Nowadays, all over the India, you can call onion as a kanda also.
Yes.
Kanda is basically a Marathi word.
Yeah.
It's very famous in the central part of the India. But all over the India, even if you say kanda, will
maybe
you write that? Even if you say kanda,
this
everybody
is
will understand.
A Marathi word.
Yeah.
But Marathi word has spreaded everywhere.
Everywhere.
And all people know what is kanda now.
Okay. So you go to any part of India, you can say pyaz or you can say kanda.
Yeah.
Okay. That is valid. Now
gajar is, or carrot is, one of the major ingredients of Chinese food also. And Indian food also, lot of gajar.
Yeah, but in Indian, in the central part of the India, the gajar is the main ingredient of the salad.
Yes.
Okay, generally we eat uncooked. Okay, just shred it and use.
It's very tasty.
Also, some sweet dish also is very famous in central part of India,
actually,
which is made by the gajar.
India, gajar ka halwa, that is a sweet dish which is famous in all weddings you will see.
Yeah,
and
everywhere you will see,
especially in winter season.
Okay, the next is tomato.
So tomato in Hindi it is called as tamatar. So little difference in pronunciation.
Yeah.
Tomato.
Now again some funny thing. If any fat kid or fat fellow is there, we generally call you are as tomato. That means you are fat and you are chubby body you have. Okay. The next we have potato.
Very common vegetable which all kids love. In fact, all adults also love. So that is called as aloo. Aloo.
So this is aloo, very famous all over the India or all over the world. You will get the dish of aloo.
Different types of dishes are prepared, and in India, in all types of vegetables, aloo is there.
Yeah.
If you go in any restaurants, you will find aloo or potato.
Maybe
many of the vegetables.
Maybe in restaurant you may not find aloo everywhere, but in homes, in each and every vegetable, the aloo is used. Aloo is always put into that. Okay. Now this is a Lady finger
is also liked by children. It is called as bindi.
Now this is also very famous in restaurants.
Yeah.
See, in Indian restaurants, generally whenever the people, Indian people go outside, they eat non-veg food. But veg food, veg vegetarian people are also there. But in restaurants, the veg variety is not as vast as your non-veg. So very selected vegetables you will get
so
in the general.
So we have taken those vegetables which you may find in all the restaurants.
Yeah, all the restaurants.
Yes.
So
there are different types of bindi or different types of lady finger preparations you will find. Dry, wet and many.
Yeah, every fried and everything you will find. Will please come this side. Now the next is the green peas.
Very common. Green peas is called as hari matar. So hari means green. And matar means peas.
I think we have seen the hari. We have seen the in the colors.
Yeah.
That is the hara. Hara is green. But here when you say it is a hari.
Yeah.
Because that is a feminine word. Matar is a feminine. So matar is matar. And in the central part you may call it the matar.
Hmm. In, especially in Maharashtra you will see the pronunciation as
matar. Okay. In Maharashtra
in
you
Hindi
call
it. Word it is matar.
Okay, so next is the beetroot.
Now beetroot is red in color and it is in Hindi called as chukandar.
Chukandar. Now in you will not find a cooked form of the beetroot anywhere
South
in
India,
India.
They make a special vegetable out of this beetroot.
But from north, central to north India, they don't use. We use only for the green salad.
Generally used in salads or in soups. They are using
soups
to make it a bright red color.
Yeah, soups and salads otherwise. And in the Indian homes, generally you will not find cooked form of this. You will find only in salads.
It's full of carotene and it is very good healthy food.
Yeah, but you will find in salads only.
Yeah.
The next is the radish.
Now radish in Hindi it is called as mooli. Mooli.
Okay, now. Beware, if you are in the central part of the India where the Marathi speaking people are there, muli means girls. Okay, so if you ask mujhe muli de do, and if the seller is Marathi, he may be confused. Ise kya chahiye? What he wants? Is he asking for girls? So be careful. So this muli is in Hindi it is radish, but in Marathi, central part of the India, muli is a plural of
girl.
Okay, next is pumpkin.
Pumpkin in Hindi is called kaddu. So kaddu is the word in Hindi. Kaddu.
Okay, so
now, since it is inside almost reddish oranges, so usko lal kaddu bhi kaha jata hai.
Sometimes it is generally in the between the shades of orange and yellow.
Shades.
orange to yellow. So it is very famous.
There's some a pumpkin festival, I think, in USA also.
In US also. And in India, pumpkin is used for vegetables also, means
salad also,
cooked vegetables, salads,
then
soups and sweet dishes. Sweet dishes are there for this. Now lemon. Now this lemon, we could have taken in the fruits also because it can go into the fruit category. But this is again an important part of Indian kitchen. So we have taken into vegetables.
Many of the vegetables, we add lemon juice.
Lemon juice.
So we can take in vegetables also and we can take in fruits also.
And this is a suppose you are going to some restaurant and they are giving this your pyaz or kanda or onion as a starter, they will definitely give you
lemon with it. They generally find lemon pieces given at the start of the food so that you can, you know, just sprinkle over over your food.
So lemon is called
in Hindi is called nimbu.
Now in the again central part of the India, they call it as a limbu. Instead of N, it is a L. It is not very common, but I'm
limbu
just...
Limbu or nimbu, you know, it means the same.
Yeah.
But you may find this difference in maybe regional things.
Regional
it
things.
It is regional where you will find little small bond difference.
Yeah. Okay. Now, I'll just tell you the many common vegetables, even if you pronounce in, even if you tell the English word, sometimes it is understood. But the special, if you say the radish, they will not understand.
They will not understand.
Okay. Yeah. But if you say the lemon, they will understand what the lemon is. Pumpkin, they may not understand. So you have to remember the common words you can pronounce in English also, tell English names. But the specific things has to be in Hindi, in the local flavor. Okay.
Yes.
Now the bottle gourd.
Bottle gourd, it looks like a bottle and long. It is called lauki in Hindi.
Lauki. Nowadays, for the heart patients and
the juice of bottle gourd
is this is a trend in India. Now everybody is going for morning walk and while coming they are drinking. They are drinking the bottle gourd juice. Now this is the bottle gourd and this is the bitter gourd.
This is dark green in color and this is called as Karela.
We will see the picture also along with this.
Karela is quite bitter. But it tastes very nice when it is made as a vegetable. Many people will not like it.
99% people will not like the taste. She may be, it may be her favorite, but 99% people won't like it. Rather, you will rarely get this vegetable in the restaurants also. Okay. Now, you have to be careful. This is a Karela and not Kerala. Kerala is a state of India. That is a Kerala.
Is K-E-R-A is Kerala. K-A-R-E means Karela.
Okay. So the difference is Karela. And the state of India is Kerala. Okay. Next is the jackfruit.
Now jackfruit can be eaten as vegetable.
Yeah.
It can be eaten as fruit. Once it is ripe,
it is fruit.
When it is not ripe, it is raw, we make a vegetable out of it.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's called as Kathal.
So this is a fruit also when the ripened state and in the
raw state
it is a vegetable. Again, this is not very common. Vegetable is not very common. You may not get this in any restaurant, but in the Hindi houses and in the central part, in the Maharashtra, Gujarat, you will
even MP,
you will definitely find in the homes. In the homes. Okay. Now last is the garlic.
Very important part of the Indian cooking.
Indian cooking, very important
garlic
part.
Garlic is called as lahasun.
Lahasun. Okay. But you can call it as a lasun. Okay.
Pronunciation is lahasun.
Okay. But that is a very pure form of Hindi. Pure. So you can, even if you call lasun, lasun, it is
now,
valid.
In Gujarat and Maharashtra, you may say lasun.
No,
and all over other India is lasun.
Lasun, but in Maharashtra, Gujarat, lasun.
Yes.
Okay. This is a very important part of the Indian cooking. Again, in the Jain food in Gujarat side, Gujarat, Rajasthan side, in the Jain food,
you may not
garlic and onion are not used. Okay. So no, actually, it happened with me also. I didn't read the board properly of the restaurant or the menu card. There are different menu cards also. By mistake, I got a Jain menu card. I didn't read anything, the title, and I ordered. After that, that was not very good of my test. Then I asked him. Then waiter told me, sir, you have ordered the Jain food. Then I saw, oh, it is a Jain.
See, it has a special taste of its own. Without garlic, without onions, it may taste different. So many people may not like.
Okay.
Jain people.
Yeah, Jain people, they are very auspicious about it. But if you are coming from outside India and if you want onion and garlic in your food, just beware. Jain food, wherever it is written, don't order that. It will be without this.
If you don't want, yes, Jain food is fine.
Yeah, if you don't want, then the Jain food is fine. So, thank you very much. Be with us.
We have covered some of the vegetables. Maybe in next video we'll cover
next
more.
Video will cover more vegetables.
Yeah.
Till then, goodbye. Again, don't forget to subscribe our channel and don't
press the bell icon.
Exactly, press the bell icon. We are waiting for your comments, your suggestions, and your questions. Thank you very much. Be with us. See you in next video.
Namaskar.